like him. As you know, our inquiry into Mars has grown well beyond its original bounds.
Finding Sagira brings up a lot of old memories. When you picked up her shell, you were able to access something left behind, a psychic fingerprint. I believe the relic awoke a new ability within you, one that reveals what lies beneath the surface. One rooted in darkness. Something tells me this witness Sabathun mentioned is directly tied to her theft of the light. We need to hear more of that fingerprint, which means you need to strengthen that ability. We've learned from the pyramid on Europa before. Head there. Eris will guide you. If my instincts are correct, this ability could be just what we need to solve this case. Pardon me. These are troubling times.
You took power from this pyramid once before, Guardian. Ikora believes there is more to be found.
How will communing with darkness help us understand the voices we heard when we found Sagira's shell?
Reach the statue at the heart of the pyramid. Strengthen your connection to the darkness, and you will see beyond the limitations of normal sight.
This pyramid granted darkness to the Guardians and the Fallen. It gives power to our enemies as easily as it gives power to us. I don't trust it. Let's just get in, take what we need, and get out.
Thank you.
Cabal shield blocking the doorway. Looks like they got up here first. Pyramid is reacting to our presence somehow. Opening doors, moving platforms.
Perhaps it senses something in you. When I explored these strange passageways, I felt it sensed something in me, too. I resented it at first. To believe it recognized in me some secret kinship. But like you, Guardian, I have learned to use it.
Cabal supplies everywhere. It looks like they're trying to establish a foothold inside the pyramid.
Hoping to pilfer artifacts of darkness for their war against war itself, I assume. Zivu Arath destroyed their homeworld, and the conquerors do not take well to being conquered.
I think that device is jamming the pyramid's movement somehow. You said the pyramid recognizes something in us, Eris. But what?
A defender. A finely honed blade. Curiosity. It could be any of those. Or none. My Cora too has asked this question, and my answer is always the same. Pure speculation. I worry the ambiguity weighs on her too heavily.
don't think the pyramid is helping us out of generosity, Guardian. It's manipulating us, using us somehow. Darkness is a neutral force, but the pyramids have an agenda. Until we know what it is, we can't let our guard down. Something must control these ships. We've never seen a pilot.
In her journeys beyond the Heliopause, Queen Mara Solve encountered the entity that commands the pyramids. She said its mind spoke louder than any other she has ever heard. A cacophony of thought. Perhaps those voices steer these ships. One of those voices spoke to you in the Black Garden as well.
Icora said that this new ability allows you to see psychic imprints of past events. And if you commune with the pyramid, you might be able to see the imprint on Sagira's shell. It's strange. The light made you forget, and now the darkness helps you remember. The Cabal are trying to destroy the statue. We have to stop them, or you won't be able to commune with the pyramid. Calling to us. Be careful, Guardian. Eris, we communed with the statue. We can't tell yet if anything has changed. It seems like we might not notice the effects until we're back in Sabathun's throne world. Either way, we don't want to stay here longer than we have to.
Wise, these ships are still a mystery to us.
I admit, even after I sent you off, I had my doubts. But Eris reports the pyramid responded to your presence. A sign that we're headed in the right direction, I think. Now that you've paid a visit to the pyramid, you should be able to reveal the memory on Sagera's shell in full. The fact you can't means there's still something we're missing. The Hidden have been analyzing the wounds you see all across the desert. The areas around them emanate with strong concentrations of psychic energy. They've located a similar concentration inside the throne world. I believe that's what we need in order to make Savathun's memory fully manifest. Take Sagira's shell there, then we'll see if I'm correct. Hopefully, this is how we'll finally find some answers. Guardian, the psychic energy my Hidden detected is concentrated in this area. Find the source, and you might be able to learn more from Sagira's shell. It's possible she learned how Savathun stole the Traveler's Light before she died. There must be some clue here. Search the area. I've delivered the general location data to your ghost, though I don't have anything precise.
I'm sensing pyramid-related interference between us and the coordinates Ikora sent. There must be a way to get around it. There. That's contributing to the interference. Maybe we can destroy it. That helped, but I'm picking up another source of interference. Let's track it down. these old, half-forgotten pathways. That power you're using is making them real again. Rebuilding them through memory.
Hopefully, Sagira's shell holds that same potential. With the right concentration of psychic energy, a resonant memory connected to her shell will manifest. But this is all theoretical still. It's never been done.
Ikora, we still haven't found anything. But I have an odd feeling. Sort of like deja vu.
That's consistent with what my hidden described. Follow that feeling. Take your time. Pick your path carefully. This is our only lead.
Once we learned Sabathun was impersonating Osiris, I wanted to believe Sagira was still alive, trapped somewhere, like him. That if we played our cards right, we'd free her too. But at least we found her. She can help us one last time, and then we can bring her home.
Thank you.
Ikora. I think we found it. There's something here.
Find the connection point. We need answers now.
Guardian, this could be big. Big enough to crack this case wide open.
Finch, a hunch is not enough. We need evidence. Compelling evidence.
Okay, how about a secret underground temple? Because I found one deep in the tunnels there. And guess who it's dedicated to?
Savathun.
Yeah, well, kinda. Dedicated to Sathona. Savathun before she was a hive god. I mean, talk about compelling. Just imagine what's buried down there.
Imagine. So you haven't seen this object?
I didn't get eyes on it per se, but I know it's powerful. Enough to attract a whole mess of scorn.
If this object is what you promise, then it'll be worth it. Stay alert, Guardian. We can't miss this one.
Even more entrenched than the last time we were here.
Oh yeah, the Scorn have dug themselves in deep down here.
Thank you.
So Finch, tell us more about this temple. How do you know it's dedicated to Sathona?
I only got a peek inside, but the statue in there looks just like her.
So Savathun built a mausoleum for her younger self, then abandoned it. Why?
I don't know. Embarrassment? Who isn't a little ashamed of their past?
Dead end. But there's an illusion here, with Savathun's signature. She didn't leave this area totally unprotected.
Why didn't she return to upgrade her defenses with the light? Why haven't the Lucent Hive come to confront the Scorn?
Oh, maybe it's fate. Maybe she's luring the Scorn in so she can convert them. Use them against the Witness.
I highly doubt Savathun would gamble her throne world for the sake of a few Scorn brigades. No. Savathun and the Witness are fighting a turf war. You don't cede ground unless you're losing.
Thank you.
So, that's the temple Sabathun dedicated to herself.
It's quite a sight, isn't it? Can't accuse Sabathun of being too humble.
There's no way to lower the bridge from here.
There has to be another path forward. Use your senses, Guardian. You've gone too far to turn back empty-handed.
On what this object's gonna be. Now, I don't technically have any glimmer, but I do have a pretty solid theory based on what we've found so far.
Now's not a good time, Finch.
Yes, don't distract the Guardian. We're already taking a gamble that this thing has the answers we need. The Traveler and the Last City are depending on it.
Look, that plate in the center should lower the drawbridge.
Thank you.
Ikora, we're lowering the drawbridge now.
Good. Once you're in, head straight for the statue Finch described. If this fits the pattern, the object should be nearby. Guardian? Ghost? Have you found the object yet?
The only thing here is the statue.
What? There's gotta be more!
Sorry, but it doesn't look like there's anything here but the statue.
Finch, please don't tell me the Guardian did all this for nothing.
No, there's something there, I swear. Wait, what if the object is the statue itself?
Or one part of the statue. That worm familiar looks like it's a separate piece.
Of course. This is Savathun's temple, after all. There had to be a trick in it. Look for where Savathun has concealed the path.
Thank you. That's impossible. That's an Ahamkara.
What? I knew the Ahamkara weren't gone. I knew there was one left. At least one.
The last one died cursing the Dreaming City. This has to be another illusion.
Ikora's right. This is an illusion. Just a very, very realistic one. One final move. We gotta find a way out, fast. Ikora, Finch, any suggestions?
We're on our own.
Let's go, Guardian.
coast. Guardian, come in. Are you there?
We're here, Ikora. We're on our way to the surface now.
And you've got the object, right? Otherwise, this was a huge waste of time.
We got it. Thanks for the concern, Finch.
Well, I never doubted you for a second. Ikora was worried, but I knew you two could handle that Ahamkara. Wasn't even a real one.
The danger was real enough. We never should have sent the Guardian in on such shaky intel. Even if it was our only lead.
Well, we made it out in one piece. And if this object shows us how Savathun got the light, the risks were worth it.
Yes. Let's hope.
Yeah. Go, team.